to transition. I want to talk about the ground state for the Kagome iceberg spin chain, a spin model. And I'm from the Institute of Physics, Chinese American Sciences. First, I'd like to thank my collaborators, Professor Guzman, also my student. So the question I'm addressed in this talk is about this kind of Kagome system, also called assessment, transfer model, of the concept. Is it GAT or Gapless? It's really a quantum screen reader. So let me first briefly mentioned about their experimental results on the proper speed lines. And actually, a few years ago, Yang Yi and his colleagues and reports beautiful scattering measurement. And now, in this work, it claimed that ground state is a gapless speed unit. But a few years later, and they changed their conclusion and claim that it's gap is a from gapless to gap spin unit. But this time into the environment. So experimentally it's still an open question whether it's a material is a gap or gapless. But they believe that it's a spin unit. Theoretically, there are many studies on this seemingly very simple model. Given claims have been made. In the early days, when many people believed that it is some kind of transform in solid space, there are also other kind of claims, especially the PMRG result. And first, the claim is spinning rate on the spinning rate of gap. By recent years, it seems that the gapless spinning rate has more work than it can report to ourselves. So, why, you ask me, you ask why the theory quite a problem is so difficult to get a conclusive answer. The method which has been used for studying this system is including DMRD. But this method has two problems. One is a very strong solid effect. Another problem is that if the size becomes very large, especially the width becomes very large, then the error grows exponentially. So this has a very strong limitation on system size. Other methods we use including version number 12. And the problem here is that you need a very accurate guess of recovery function. Basically, you need some other answers in order to guess the results. Polynomial optimization is a good method. Unfortunately, for this strong crossing system has a man cycle. So what we want to do is to use tensor network space using the remember digital method to study this problem. This method, which is the most accurate method for studying a large system. We hope we can gain insights also by making comparison between the Kagome language and also the Kusumi language. Kusumi language is a simplified language, and Kagome language, and has local similar metal structure, but less conflict. So that's the strategy we want to use here to solve this problem. So let me first give you a very simple, very brief introduction of tensor graph states. Yesterday, Nvidia already mentioned about this. So tensor graph states is basically a trivial function or version of a function. And that can be systematically improved by increasing the virtual basis states. So this is on each next slide, there's a tensor. And also on each bound, think there are virtual basis states. So the virtual states, the number of each bound, the number b here, and here b is the virtual basis number. This virtual basis number can be increased. In principle, if this b goes to infinity, then you should get your accurate, almost exactly function. So this is roughly the form of this kind of tensor of states. So this is a network of tensors. For example, this one, because each size has four neighbors, so you have a 4-index for virtual basis states. So this is a 4-index tensor. This is the M here is visible basis states. This is W box. Well, spin on half system is M and in two values, just half spin down spin, two. And so the total number of parameters on each nano size is two times d to the power of 4. So the number of parameters, version of parameters, that can be optimized by RT method. The good thing that for this kind of function, we can directly trace the infinity lattice system by using translation words. Generally, the ground state energy converges very fast with the increase of the bound energy. Especially if the system is gapped, then the convergence very quickly, exponentially. If the ground state is gapped less, then the energy ground state energy should converge in sort of power law of D. So this is also the method we use to determine whether the ground state is gapped or gapless. Because it's gapless, then you should have virtues on the power law behavior. If it's gapped, it should converge. As I have no time to talk about the detail how this method works, I can just show you some results which can be obtained with this type of method. For comparison with Sir Conacolo for the three-dimensional messing mode. I'll just give you a rough idea how good this method can be. It's a comparison between the tensor transition group method and Monte Carlo for magnetization and also for the specific heat. So just from this figure, the difference is very, very small. Here I use a bound dimension 14. That means that each virtual bound dimension corresponds to the maximum number of basis states is 14. In this case, the difference, the relative difference between these two measures is actually less than 10 to minus 5. Also, from this singular behavior, we can determine the critical temperature. So, this estimation will obtain this method for keeping this vertical dimension equal to 23. So this is converging the number of the transition temperature. It's also comparison with given that the method. atoms. This can be very accurate if you use this number of bond dimension. Actually, in for fitting this quantum system, which is much more complicated than three-dimensional atom, then we have to calculate expectation values. So this will be a function. This will be a function. In order to calculate expectation values, we need to put two tensor narrow states. One on the top of another one. This is our, in this case, the boundary wall, the physical wall, already contracted. So if you do this, we face first term contracting this version of this boundary wall, physical basis state, then in principle, this tensor narrows from this one. The only difference between this one and this one is that the bond dimension now is squared. If this is d, for example, is 1/10, then square is 100. So then it's bond dimension is 100. If we do this way, then generally computational cost is very high. So this is around in the orange of this computation. So this gives the number of d, okay? Using the computer available, in the world, and generally the D is very difficult to be much more than 30. So 30 or 40 almost less. But in order to get larger D, in our calculation, instead of contracting this physical bond, we just shifted this top layer of the network and shifted it and pressed the bond. And this form nested tensor arrow steps. In this case, this special one is still, we do not, as contrary to the first. In this case, the maximum bond dimension is still D, not disturbed. By doing this, we can reduce computational cost from D to the power of 12 and to D to the power of 8. This is when plus D from 13 to 25 or even to 30. So this is the strategy we use for solving this problem. Another thing we, as I mentioned, we use is to make a comparison between this Kagome matrix and this Xiang matrix. The Xiang matrix is actually a basal matrix. It's locally similar to this one. But it's just angle. But the good thing is right here, that this is a very, there's some loops here, only three sides. The next loop is just three sides. So this kind of matrix has a trace structure and also the tensor network method works very well because in this case, D can reach almost 1,000. So you can get very, very accurate results for bond sets. So we don't want to make a comparison to this one and this one. Because for the Kagome matrix, generally D is very small in comparison to 1,000. And we first show you some results obtained from the SMR model on Xiang matrix. This Xiang matrix runs edge, cross, converge, algebraically. Or similarly for the magnetization. This magnetization of finite beam is always balanced. But when the bond dimension goes to infinity, it converges to zero. So for this system, Xiang matrix SMR model, the ground state is a speed limit, also gapless speed limit. For comparison, I also make just two calculations for speed one for speed matrix. This is very like a spin chain. Okay? Sigma half spin chain and spin one chain. That's normal. In this case, bond state is actually trimerized. So most energy actually converge exponentially. Similarly, of this magnetization as function by magnetic field. So you can see the difference between spin of half and spin one. But spin one, that's bad, so you can see there's a gap here. So spin of half, that's no gap. And it's one third plateau of magnetization. Now let me show you the results for the Kagome dynamics. This is our bond state H as a function of bond dimension. You are seeing this up to D equal to 25. The result hasn't converted yet, or not exponentially converted. So this is our huge start and the power law beginning. So the issue is that the system is gapless. Of course, it's bond dimension. Still not that big, still 25, although the results are already quite accurate. So this is a comparison between constituent ideas. So this is how bond state converges, and this is a Kagome ideas. But it's a very similar power law behavior, although here it's much shorter than this one. So for this comparison, we prove that this system must be a gapless system. If it's not gapless, then the gap must be extremely small. Otherwise, we'll see some kind of convergence, exponential convergence. So this indicates that the system either have a very tiny gap or gapless. So this is magnetization. In order to see whether this system is magnetic order frame or F-magnetic order. For each finite bound dimension, we indeed found that magnetization is finite. But for comparison, if you see that in Kagome dynamics, the magnetization for Kagome dynamics is always smaller than Kagome dynamics, as we expect, because Kagome dynamics is much less frustrating. So this is a comparison. It's always below that. So this is a constituent magnet. As I mentioned, the convergence to zero. For the Kagome analysis, it must also be zero because every point must be below this green triangle. So this this system, a Kagome-Hessler system, must be spin invert. There's no magnetic order. So based on those results, we claim that this Kagome-Hessler model is a spin invert and also gapless. In order to see how stable is on stage against other than reactions, we also studied the Hessler model with the years later and also with next year's later. So by adding this term in, you want to say how stable this kind of one state is certain. Purely Hessler model is either. By adding this term in, we found that actually this state become unstable here. If the GH2 is negative, then the system will become root 3 by root 3 magnetic order. On the other hand, if GH2 is very large but positive, it also one state will become this so called P to 0 magnetic order states. So on the both sides of the system, they are magnetic order. One is the Q. field and the order, this is just a conventional 120 degrees year long. This is a group three by group three magnetic order. But in the middle of this two phase, actually we found that there's a gradient. The stiffness fermion, the stiffness gapless, gapless spin equilibrium, that is stable. Unfortunately, we cannot determine the phase boundary on this side because it's very difficult to determine this phase boundary. So we can roughly estimate the phase boundary from here. Region, we cannot determine the size of the vibration. This big or not is what the report is. So basically, we think that there are three phases on this side and this side, we have an order phase, but in the middle, there's a spinning phase. Okay, so that's the result I want to show you. So basically, we made a large computational study on this iceberg polar magnetics. Often the results suggest that it runs the gap speed. Thank you very much for your attention.
Yeah, this is a good question. If you solve this hexameron on the dominant, it's memorized.
here we assume, we experiment on boundary conditions. We assume that all directions should be the same. That's all the boundary condition. If we look at impulse system and boundary condition, the growth state, as you mentioned, must be memorized. That's exactly. It's also hugely determined. But here, we, because in order to compare with Kagome net, we cannot assume that kind of growth state. We need to assume that the growth state must be continuous around all directions, all isotropic around all directions.
Yes, so as you can.
Magnetization, you mean you take m squared and compute that? What do you mean by magnetization? And can you analytically relate the, if it is gapless, the spectral properties to how it will vanish as a function of t?
You mean the magnetization?
The magnetization, yes.
Should vanish as function b in certain power?
What is it? What is the magnetization?
What do you mean by magnetization?
This is just 100 degree this that near order.
Okay, but presumably that is zero, right?
It is a finite degree for this because we use this wave function. This is a wave function. If a boundary element is finite, then it picks up like order set. It's only true when they push this D close to infinity acceleration. So the order becomes zero in the nearest D close to infinity.
Can you predict how it goes to zero?
Yes, I think it's zero. Because we'll see the answer.
Suppose you know how the spin wave or whatever information spectrum, like what David used it for the square lattice. You know how the spin wave spectrum behaves at low energy, or
yeah,
whatever information spectrum you have. Mm-hmm. And you relate that to the power of T, how it vanishes with what power?
To read in all the exponents, sir, there's an exponent.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's thank